Hello guys, in this video we are going to discuss about the Markovnikov's rule and also anti-Markovnikov's rule, which is also known as Kharash effect. So what is Markovnikov's rule? This rule essentially tells us what will be the product during an electrophilic addition reaction between a unsymmetrical alkene. This is an unsymmetrical alkene. So when this alkene will react with any hydrogen halide, where X equals to chlorine, bromine or iodine, then Markovnikov's rule basically tells us what will be the product. So according to Markovnikov's rule, the hydrogen will go or will add or will form a carbon hydrogen bond with that carbon which already has highest number of hydrogen atoms attached with it. So hydrogen will go to this CH2 carbon atom and the halogen will go to the carbon atom which contains least amount of hydrogen atom. So the CH carbon will make a single bond with the halogen atom. So this is basically Markovnikov's rule. So we have to understand what is the mechanistic reason behind this type of addition product. So if we consider the mechanism of this reaction, okay, first of all the reaction should be in a non-nucleophilic solvent, let's say for example carbon tetrachloride. If any nucleophile is present, then what will happen I will tell you. So in a non-nucleophilic solvent like carbon tetrachloride, the hydrogen halide, which will be inherently polarized in this fashion, the hydrogen will be del plus character, halogen will be del minus, since halogen is more electronegative than the hydrogen atom. So it will eventually pull the bonding electrons towards it by a minus I effect. So in this polarized state, obviously an initial interaction between the pi electron cloud of the starting alkene and the hydrogen halide will take place. This is an example of complex. So this type of complex are essentially called pi complex. Which will then form a sigma complex. Here the interaction is very weak interaction. So this pi complex will be converted into a sigma complex. So how the sigma complex will form? This double bond will dissociate and will attack this hydrogen atom. So here the breaking of double bond is crucial. If the double bond breaks like this, then this carbocation will form. But if the double bond breaks like this, then this carbocation will form. So now from your previous knowledge of carbocations, you can easily tell that this carbocation is highly stable due to the secondary nature of it, and also there are 6 hyperconjugable hydrogen atoms which will stabilize the carbocationic center, and also the plus I effect of the methyl groups. Here only 2 hyperconjugable hydrogen atoms are present, and also the overall plus I effect of this ethyl group will be in action. So this will be very unstable carbocation. So the formation of this carbocation will be thermodynamically favorable. So after the formation of this carbocation, the X minus, which is present in the reaction medium as a nucleophile, will of course attack this cationic center. And the product will form, which is satisfied with the Markovnikov's rule. So we can understand now that the Markovnikov's rule is highly explainable in terms of carbocationic stability. In another instance, where actually we can say that the carbocation is forming during the reaction, is this. When this alkene is treated with HBr or HI, we can easily say from the Markovnikov's rule that the product molecule will be this one, but it is not found after the reaction. The actual product was found to be this one. So how can we explain the formation of this product? So one thing we can say that here essentially a carbocationic rearrangement is taking place during the reaction. So initially what will happen, the double bond will be attacked by the HX. X minus will stay in the reaction medium for the latter step. So here will be the carbocation, and this CH2 will be converted into the CH3 group. So now this is a secondary carbocationic center. So from our previous knowledge of carbocationic rearrangement or Wagner-Meerwein type of rearrangement, we can predict that a 1,2 methyl shift can take place here. So after the shift, the new carbocation will be more stable than the starting carbocation. So this will be the new carbocation. Now the positive charge is on a 3-degree carbocationic center. So this is more stable than this carbocation. So after that, the Br minus or I minus will attack the carbocationic center and the product will form. So we can easily explain this type of addition reaction in terms of by considering Markovnikov's rule and carbocationic rearrangement. Okay, so what will happen if any nucleophilic species is present in the reaction medium? So consider this alkene molecule. And let's say there is a nucleophile is present in the reaction medium. So after, in the first step, the carbocation will form. So now there will be a competition between Br minus or X minus and the nucleophile, which is also present in the reaction medium. So either our desired product will form BR or X, or the product, the new product will form, which will contain the nucleophile in place of the bromine atom or the halogen atom. Although the formation of this product will also satisfy the Markovnikov's rule, but this is not our desired product. So in order to inhibit or in order to suppress the formation of this kind of additional byproduct, we need to carry out the electrophilic addition reaction between alkene and hydrogen halide in absence of any nucleophile. So if the solvent molecule has some nucleophilic property, let's say we are carrying out the reaction not in carbon tetrachloride but in presence of water molecule, or let's say a alcoholic solvent, then what will happen? Alcohol and water both contains oxygen atom which has lone pair. So essentially it has some nucleophilic character. So the water molecule or the alcohol molecule will act as a nucleophile, and this type of product will be generated during the reaction. So to avoid those types of product formation, we have to perform the reaction also in absence of any nucleophilic solvent. So now one interesting aspect of Markovnikov's rule is that when the addition reaction between HBr and propene will be carried out in presence of a peroxide, let's say benzoyl peroxide, this will be in catalytic amount. The product was found to be totally opposite to that of Markovnikov's product. So here the hydrogen will go into the carbon which has least number of hydrogen atom attached with it, and the bromine will add to the carbon which has more number of hydrogen atoms already attached with it. So this type of abnormality in Markovnikov's product is called anti-Markovnikov's rule or anti-Markovnikov's product or peroxide effect or Kharash effect. So what is the reason behind it? The reason is very simple. We have a peroxide in our reaction medium. In this case, it is benzoyl peroxide. So a little amount of heat will dissociate this peroxide bond in a homolytic fashion. And homolytic fashion leads to the formation of radicals. You all know that. So two benzoyl radical will be generated after the homolytic bond cleavage. So this peroxide, this radical will now abstract a, so radicals are highly reactive species, so they will look for a chemical entity or molecule which will react with this radical and thereby form a stable product, more stable product. So this radical is not stable, so due to its high reactivity, it will try to react with any other species which is present in the reaction medium. So in this case, the most suitable candidate will be HBr. So this O dot will abstract the proton from HBr, and this will lead to the formation of Br dot. So why proton is abstracted but not the bromine? Because Br dot is more stable than H dot. Due to large size and less electronegativity of Br dot of bromine, Br dot is found to be highly stable. So this Br dot will now react with the propene, which is present in our reaction medium. So this addition will now follow the Markovnikov's path. Suppose we have propene. So the double bond will break in a fashion where the most stable radical will be generated. So obviously, if the double bond breaks like this, then this CH2 will attack this Br dot, and the corresponding intermediate will be this one. If the bromine atom is attached with this carbon, then this radical should form as the intermediate. But we all know that the stability of a primary radical is very less compared to a secondary radical. So due to the higher stability, this radical will form in the reaction mixture, and after that it will react with HBr, attack the hydrogen of this HBr molecule, and this product will form. So we can see that this step will eventually lead to the formation of another Br dot, which will then react with another molecule of propene. So the reaction will go in a chain fashion. So this is a radical chain reaction. So the initiation, there is also initiation chain, initiation step and termination step. So what is the initiation step? The formation of these two radicals are the first step, that is the radical initiation step. So like this the reaction will proceed. So now we can understand how the anti-Markovnikov's product is formed when there is a peroxide present in the reaction medium in a catalytic amount. So this is basically the overall mechanism of Markovnikov's addition or Markovnikov's rule and the effect of peroxide present during the addition reaction between a alkene and hydrogen halide. And one more important thing is the peroxide effect is applicable only for HBr. It is not applicable for HCl or HI. Since in case of these two acids, the steps will be endothermic and their formation or their occurrence during the reaction will be not thermodynamically favorable. That's why the peroxide effect was found to be no effect when the hydrogen halide is either HCl or HI. So peroxide effect will be only seen when the hydrogen halide is HBr. So this is the overall mechanism of Markovnikov's rule. I hope that this video gave you some insight into the mechanistic aspects of Markovnikov's product and also anti-Markovnikov's rule and Kharash effect. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, then please subscribe to my channel. It will help me a lot. Thank you. See you in the next video.